Okay, today in our studies, we are coming to a philosophy which is very familiar to us, that is pragmatism.
今天我们要提到一个我们非常熟悉的哲学，就是实用主义。
Now, I've mentioned earlier in the first session that it is one of the subdivision of the broad generic perspective of what we call secularism.
我在之前的那一堂课提过，这个实用主义是世俗主义广义观点的其中一个分支。
Now, before I start, can I have a show of hand? How many of you have not heard of the term pragmatism? Raise your hand.
我想知道你们当中谁从来没有听过实用主义，请举手。
Anyone? Okay, just one.Two, three, four, not many, okay?
不是很多。
No, all right. I would think that most people are frightened by words such as existentialism, logical positivism, and so on.
我相信有些人会被存在主义或是逻辑证实主义等给吓到了。
But pragmatism sounds much easier and resonating.
但是实用主义听起来更加容易，而且更能引起共鸣。
Now, I tell you why, because I studied politics in university.
我在大学是修读政治学的。
And it's often said by political scholars that our founding father, LKY, values pragmatism over ideology. He values practice over theory.
然后政治学者经常说我们的国父李光耀看重实用主义胜过意识形态，看重实践胜过理论。
And the way he had led our nation has made us nothing but pragmatists.
然后他领导这个国家的方式让我们变得更加务实。
But of course we have to qualify that.
当然我们要加以说明。
Because some others think that LKY is not just pragmatist, he also care about principle.
因为还有人认为李光耀不单只是一个不是一个不讲原则的实用主义者。
But he managed to blend the two so well, pragmatist and principle,such that you know, Singapore became such, so successful in just within a few decades.
但是他成功地将两者完美地融合在一起，这就是为什么我们国家在短短几十年能够取得成功的理由。
But whichever it is, we cannot deny pragmatism has a heavy influence on our culture, and it has become our Singapore society's way of life.
但无论如何，我们都不能否认实用主义对我们的文化产生了重大的影响，以致它已经成为我们社会的生活方式。
You know, when I was studying the contemporary politics of China, one of the most classic description of pragmatism was by Chairman Deng Xiaoping.
我记得我在大学念中国当代政治时，对实用主义最经典的描述之一就是邓小平主席的一句著名比喻。
In his famous metaphor of cats, some of you might heard it before, he said, it doesn't matter whether a cat is black or white, as long it catches mice.
你们可能很熟悉他的一句名言，他说不管黑猫白猫，能抓到老鼠的就是好猫。
And you may not know, actually, Deng Xiaoping is one of the most respected person by LKY.
其实李光耀其中最尊敬的人之一就是邓小平。
So it was said that these people are all pragmatists.
所以这些人都被视为是实用主义者。
But anyway, have any of us wonder where pragmatism as a worldview originates from?
但是我们当中有人知道实用主义这个世界观是源自哪里吗？
Now, most of the philosophical movements that impact the world usually come from Europe because of its rich cultural roots.
一般上影响世界的哲学运动大多来自欧洲，因为欧洲是有着丰富的文化根源的。
But not so for pragmatism.
但实用主义并非如此。
Pragmatism as a formal philosophy was developed and expanded in the United States.
实用主义是在美国发展为一种正式的哲学。
And the reason why pragmatism was so popular and in this contemporary culture especially, as what RC observed, it reflects the genius of the American culture itself.
实用主义之所以在当代文化中如此盛行，如同史普罗观察到的，是因为它反映了美国文化本身的某些天才。
Now, I want to point you to a book that was published in the 1960s that made a surprising impact both within the church and in the intellectual world because of its semi-popular work of philosophy and religion.
有一本书在1960年代出版，因为其中的这个半流行哲学和宗教著作而在教会和知识界产生了令人惊讶的影响。
It was a book by Professor Harvey Cox, who is an American professor in Harvard School, and the title was The Circular City.
他的作者是哈佛神学院的美国神学家哈维·考克斯。他写了一本书，名叫《世俗之城市》。
Now, what Dr. Cox was trying to do in that little book is to write something that was somewhat similar to St. Augustine's classic work, The City of God.
考克斯博士在那本书中试图写的内容是与圣奥古斯丁的经典著作《上帝之城》有些相似。
And the very title, The Circular City, calls attention to the change in the Western civilization from a culture and a society that looked to God for its values, that looked heavenward for its goal and destination, to now a modern culture which we've seen in secularism, existentialism, and humanism.
世俗之城这个标题引起了人们对西方文明的转变的关注。西方文明从一个以上帝为价值观、以天堂为目标和目的的社会和文化，转变为我们现在所看到的世俗主义、存在主义和人本主义的现代文化。
And this culture of secular city has more or less abandoned the eternal and spiritual as the reference point for its shaping and formation.
这种世俗城市文化或多或少放弃了以永恒和属灵的参照点来形成和塑造自己。
And what Dr. Cox said is the American society now no longer lives in the city of God. In fact, now lives in the circular city.
考克斯博士其实是在告诉美国社会，我们现在不是活在上帝之城，而是世俗之城。
And what he was trying to do was to apply the American culture to the American culture a yardstick of evaluation through theological and sociological perspective.
他试图通过神学和社会学的视角对美国文化应用一个评价尺度。
Of course, some felt that he's a better sociologist than a theologian.
当然，有些人认为他是一个更好的社会学者，超过他是一个神学家。
But he made some interesting observations about the American society.
但是他对美国社会提出了一些有趣的观察。
He talks about the shape and style of America.
他谈论美国的形态和风格。
And when he evaluates the style of America, he points immediately.To pragmatism as being the dominant influence in the producing of American life.
当他评价美国的风格时，他立即指出实用主义是美国人生活的主导影响力。
And what he used as the symbol that embodied pragmatism is none other than the late American President John F. Kennedy.
而他所用的实用主义象征正是美国已故总统肯尼迪。
So Cox sees Kennedy as the supreme example of American pragmatism.
考克斯认为肯尼迪是美国实用主义的最高典范。
And one interesting short quote by him in passing here, I'm going to read to you.
他其中我要引用他的一句话。
Now I have it up there here, all right? Okay, now this is what Cox said. The urban circular man is pragmatic. He devotes himself to tacklingspecific problems and is interested in what will work to get something done. He has little interest in what has been termed borderline questions of metaphysical consideration. He wastes little time thinking about the ultimate or religious questions.
考克斯这么说，城市世俗人是务实的，他致力于解决具体问题。并且对如何有效完成某件事感兴趣。他对所谓的形而上学思考的边缘问题不太感兴趣。他很少浪费时间思考终极问题或宗教问题。他说实用主义精神就是解决问题的精神。实用主义者
And as he went on to explain here, now this is what he concluded, okay? That the spirit of pragmatism is the spirit of what? Of problem solving.And the pragmatist is basically either skeptical or agnostic about man's ability to discover ultimate truths.
他所得到的结论就是实用主义精神就是解决问题的精神。实用主义者基本上对人类发现终极真理的能力 持怀疑或不可知态度。
I don't want you to grasp all of this, okay? Now, Dr. Cox somehow captured the gist of what pragmatism looks like in America and probably in Singapore.
我认为考克斯在某种程度上掌握了实用主义者他在美国还有甚至新加坡的影响力。
And so, pragmatist says, I don't have time in my life to figure out all the mysteries that are clouded in the universe about the ultimate reality or the ultimate purpose, and all sorts of things that have to be involved with religion or philosophy that they have been always concerned about.
实用主义者说，我一生中没有时间去弄清楚宇宙中关于终极现实和终极目的的所有奥秘，以及宗教和哲学关心的所有事情。
I have to be busy with living.
我得忙着生活。
And my life involves encountering a myriad of problems.
我的生活将会遇到无数的问题。
And so, what do I do every day? I have to find solutions to these problems.
所以我必须找到解决这些问题的方法。
So the basic question that will be asked by the hardcore pragmatist is, what works?
因此那铁杆实用主义者会问的基本问题是什么才是有效的
What works is the ultimate question, not what is fanciful or pleasing to the intellect in terms of theology or ideology. You know.
什么是行得通的才是他们关心的最终问题而不是理论或意识形态方面什么是奇特的令人愉悦的
We don't care about what theory you have. It's the results. It's what works.That matters.
他们不管你有什么理论，他们最终关注的是能够带来结果吗
？And you've asked them what results?
如果你问他们怎样的结果
，And say that depends on what you want.
他们会说那跟你想要的有关。
What do you want? You ask yourself.
那你问你想要什么
？For instance, how to score all A's for PSLE?
例如在小六会考当中考得好成绩。
For the singles, how to get a date?
或者是如何有恋爱对象
？Or How to resolve the problem of my infertility?
或是怎么解决我的不孕的问题
How to grow my wealth?
怎么让我的财富增值
How to retire earlier?
怎么能够提早退休
And what works is what the pragmatist is interested in, and all these can be probably gotten from the internet these days.
实用主义者感兴趣的是什么有效，什么是行得通的，而这些都是可以从互联网上找到的
But again, as a form of philosophy,Pragmatism proceeds from a prior skepticism towards metaphysics or theology.
然而，作为一种哲学，实用主义源于先前与形而上学或神学的怀疑主义。
Now, I just mentioned metaphysics. What is metaphysics? Some people ask me. Now, this is an everyday word for the philosopher, but not common for the man on the street.
那有些人问什么是形而上学这个词对哲学家来说是一个日常用语但对于一般人来说却不是如此
Now I'm sure we heard of the word metaverse now, right?
我相信我们都对元宇宙很熟悉
Facebook has rebranded to metaverse
因为脸书已经将自己改名为元宇宙
But what's meta means?
但是 meta 这个意思元是什么意思
Meta means beyond, right?
它的意思是超越
Beyond And what is physics?
然后物理学又是什么
I'm sure we all study physics.
我们都学过物理学。
Now physics is probably concern of the organized, it's a natural science, and it concerns the physics of the study of order and behavioral forces in nature.
物理学就是对自然界的秩序和行为力量的研究。
Now, we all know about this stuff, about F equals MA, all those study physics.
那些学过物理学的，我们听过这个方程式 F equal to MA.
And it's a natural science, so to speak.
那个是一个自然科学。
But when we talk about metaphysics, now we are not talking about this order and behavioral forces in nature.
但是形而上学不是只有对物理学或自然界的研究。
We are talking about something beyond what you could see in the natural order.
我们谈论的是超越你在这个自然界所能够看到的。
So it is supra or supernatural.
换句话说，它是超自然的。
So metaphysics look beyond what we can be seen and observed in the sphere of natural science and ask ultimate questions.
形而上学超越了自然科学领域所能看到和观察到的事，而提出了终极问题。
For instance, what is the ultimate reality?
比如说什么是终极现实
Is there a God or is there not a God?
到底有神还是没神
Where does life come from?
生命从哪里来
What is the whole meaning of life?
生命的全部意义是什么是什么
Now metaphysics deal with such questions.
形而上学就是关心这类的问题
And men for centuries have sought to unravel mysteries of metaphysics.
几个世纪以来，人们一直在寻求解开形而上学的奥秘。
In fact, it has always been believed every fundamental question to a question starts from a metaphysics question.
事实上，人们一直认为每一个根本性的问题都是从一个形而上学的问题开始的。
And for instance, you ask, why is this world so beautiful?
你问，比如说，为什么这个世界那么漂亮
？Now you got to go on and ask then.Who created this world? Is there a creator of this beautiful world?
然后你就要问，这个美丽的世界有一个创造者吗？
That's why I say every fundamental question to a question starts from a metaphysics question.
所以我说每一个根本性的问题都是从一个形而上学的问题开始的。
But a period of skepticism came in after the Enlightenment, which is around 19th century,
但启蒙运动之后出现了一段怀疑主义时期，那个是在19世纪发生的。
They are skeptical of anything that is transcendent that cannot be seen.
所以人们对一切超自然的、不能看到的东西都持怀疑态度。
And at the same time, enormous advances were being made in man's ability to cope with this world.
与此同时，人类应对世界的能力取得了巨大的进步。
And particularly, I'm sure some of you have heard of the Industrial Revolution, the breakthrough in science and medicine and so on.
特别随着的是工业革命、科学 和医学的突破。
And there was a sense that man find himself able to cope with the limitations brought about by nature.
所以人类就觉得自己可以应对自然所带来的限制。
For instance, they invented the light bulb to shine the dark, invented engines to run vehicles, and using modern medicine and so on.
比如说人类能够发明灯泡来应付黑暗，能够发明发动机来有车辆。
And then with industrialization, men no longer work from home, selling things that they've made.
然后随着工业化的发展，人不在家中工作，出售他们制作的东西。
Men, even women, start selling their time to factory owners, and goods were mass-produced.
男人甚至女人开始把自己的时间卖给工厂老板，商品开始批量生产。
So there is this new realms of work in 19th-20th century.
所以在19还有20世纪就有了一个新的工作领域。
Everything becomes faster, more efficient, more productive.
一切都变得更快、更高效、更有生产力。
And so here, the modern man starts to say, "Hey, I don't have time now."
所以现代人开始就说，我现在没有时间。
I am so involved in working out my life, and we are getting answers to our problems now.
我全身心投入到自己的生活当中，我们的问题也得到了答案。
We have learned to look at this scientific community to resolve the problem of cancer, heart disease, and so on.
我们学会了通过科学来解决癌症、心脏病等问题。
We are already getting it.
我们应付得很好。
So who has time now to fool around with metaphysics consideration?
那么现在谁还有时间去多想形而上学的问题呢？
And so a whole philosophy emerged that look at life from the non-metaphysics side, from a perspective of naturalism, natural science,and try to frame a whole philosophy of living based on that.
因此一整套哲学就出现了，它从非形而上学的角度，从自然主义、自然科学的角度来看待生活，并试图在这基础上构建一套完整的生活哲学。
And what do we call that? We call that pragmatism.
然后我们称之为实用主义。
Now, there is, let me go on, make you understand, there is an easy point,of confusion between Christianity and pragmatism.
基督教和实用主义之间很容易混淆。
Because in our everyday, everyday use of vocabulary, we always tend to use the word pragmatic as a synonym for practical.
因为在当今通用的词汇当中，我们经常把实用和实际当作同义词。
Do you want to be practical?
你想要实际吗？
Yes, of course, we want to be practical.
当然我们想要实际。
And I as a pastor get this all the time from people.
作为牧师我很明白人要的是这个。
I always have people telling me, oh, we don't have time for theology.
很多时候人就告诉我我没有时间研究神学。
We don't have time for lengthy Bible study for something that is too theoretical.
我没有时间参加漫长的查经或是太理论的东西。
We want to be practical.
我们要实际。
Because doesn't God at the end really care about how we practice His words more than anything else, right?
因为说到底，上帝真正的关心难道不是我们如何实践他的话过于其他事吗？
And people start quoting the Bible and says, didn't Jesus say, by their fruits you will know them? It's the fruits that's important.
然后他们就引用圣经说，圣经也说，凭着他们的果子就能认出他们来，所以是强调果子。
And Book of James say, if any one of you says to your brother, go in peace, keep warm and well fed, but does nothing about his physical needs, what good it is?
然后雅各书说，你们中间有人对他说，平平安安的去吧，愿你们穿得暖，吃得饱，却不给他身体所需用的，这有什么益处呢？
So yes, we all know there is this practical aspect of the Bible.
所以我们都知道圣经有实际方面。
And a handful of evangelical believers are always using this as a notion of legitimacy for their practical faith in replace of what is theological.
少数福音派信徒总是将这一个概念作为他们实际信仰的合法性，以取代神学信仰。
Now I know that. I've been there with people before.
我很清楚 这一切。
I know it's very easy to be touched by someone who lend a helping hand to you when you are needy.
我知道当你有需要的时候人家帮助你你很容易受感动。
It's easy to be touched by people who does home visitation, you know, or practically helping ex-convict, addict, drug addicts, or the poor and broken.
我们很容易被那些有做家庭探访实际帮助前囚犯、吸毒者、穷人等等的人而被感动。
And in fact, by their practice, we say we know. That's what they believe.
借着他们的实践，我们知道他们的想法。
And God from the beginning has always been very concerned about how we live out our faith in practice, right?
神从一开始就非常关心我们如何在实际中实践我们的信仰。
So I'll say Christianity, or I as a pastor, I'm not against practical works.
基督教甚至我身为一个牧师我们不反对实际工作。
I as a pastor has to run the church in a way that is practical.
我作为主任牧师必须以实际的方式来带领教会。
But what I'm trying to say is that the pragmatist is very much concerned about being practical, but so are we Christians.
但我想说的是实用主义者非常注重实用性。基督徒也是如此。
The Christian is also concerned about practice and being practical.
基督徒也关心实践和实际。
But being practical does not mean you must embrace pragmatism as a philosophy of life.
但实际并不代表必须将实用主义视为一种生活哲学。
Being practical does not mean having a view that everything that works is right.
实际并不意味着认为一切有效的都是正确的。
In fact, when the tension comes, where the collision occurs between Christianity and pragmatism, which I'll explain later, is that Christianity asserts that ultimately pragmatism as a philosophy is impractical.
事实上基督教与实用主义之间的紧张关系和冲突我等一下后面会多详细解释这个冲突就在于基督教断言实用主义是一个最不切实际的哲学
Now you got what I mean? You see, just as we think pragmatism is about being practical
我们以为实用主义就是要实际
But Christianity says No, you're wrong, you're deceived Pragmatism is most impractical
然而基督教说不你错了实用主义是最不切实际的。
In fact, it is approaching practicality wrongly.
事实上，它错误地对待实用性。
Now, this is where I want all of us here to be really careful about distinguishing between what is of practical and what is pragmatism.
因此，我希望大家非常小心地区分实际和实用或是务实。
Now, the Christian must get a point of distinction here.
基督徒必须清楚地理解其中的区分点。
Now, probably let's go to Romans 1. to explain my point, okay?
为了阐明我的观点，我们一起来看罗马书第一章。
And Romans 1, you don't have to turn there. Romans 1 is a chapter I've always touched on when I speak about the reprobation of man.
当我谈到人的遗弃时，我总是会提到这一章。
And over there, Paul was explaining God's judgment is being manifested to the world.
在那里，保罗解释神向世界彰显他的审判。
And why is that so?
那为什么呢？
Because God reveals himself to man through ways that are simply found in nature.
因为神通过自然界中常见的方式向人启示自己。
God is easily and clearly seen in nature.
神是在自然界中很容易也很清晰能够看见的。
But Romans 1:18 says, the bottom line is man does not see fit to take seriously the knowledge of God.
然而罗马书一章十八节告诉我们，人不认为应该认真对待有关神的知识。
And over there it says he suppresses the truth.
所以人就压制真理。
Either by ignoring the existence of God cavalierly, or he does not approve the idea of spending much time thinking or learning about the character of God.
他们不是傲慢地忽视神的存在，就是不赞成花太多时间思考或认识神的品格。
And therefore, if you read on, God gives man over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not proper.
因此神任凭人存邪僻的心去行不正当的事。
And you know Romans 1, you know, and then it ended with a catalog of vices.
然后罗马书第一章就以一系列的罪恶作为结尾。
Envy, murder, strife, deceit, malice.
嫉妒、凶杀、争竞、诡诈、毒恨。
And they became gossipers, slanderers, God-haters, insolent, arrogant, boastful, and so on.
所以背后就说人，然后怨恨神，侮慢人。狂傲自夸的。
And at the end of Romans 1, Paul gives this dreadful list of human vices.
在罗马书的第一章后面，保罗列出了这个可怕的人类罪恶清单。
But the point that the apostle is making is that there is a natural consequences. That is when man will not have God in his thoughts. That immediately is reflected in what man does practically.
使徒要带出来的是一种自然的结果，就是当人的思想中没有上帝时，这会立即反映在人的实际行为当中。
So if you, as a pragmatist, thinks that God is not worthy of your mental consideration,
所以如果你身为一个实用主义者，认为神不值得你的精神考量，
that will ultimately have a massive impact on your life and the style of your life.
那最终会大大的影响你的生活和生活方式。
How can it not be?
这怎么不会这样呢？
Now, indeed, there is a sense that not everybody is theologically oriented.
确实并不是每个人都以神学为导向。
But everybody is involved in practice, right?
但每一个人都参与实践。
Philosophers have to live, non-philosophers also have to live.
哲学家必须生活，非哲学家也必须生活。
We are all involved in the practice of living.
我们都参与生活的实践当中
，eating, playing, talking, interacting, making appropriate decisions.
吃饭、玩乐、交谈、互动，做出适当的决定。
You see, we are living all the time, and how you live can be seen.
我们无时无刻都在生活，而你怎么活是能够看得见的。
But whether it's a sophisticated, formally developed concept or not, how we live and what we live is the clearest expression of what our theories are.
但无论是否是一个复杂的或是正式形成的概念，我们的生活和行为都是最清晰的表达我们的理论的。
Listen carefully. Nobody operates without a theory.
没有人会在没有理论的情况下运作。
You may not be able to articulate it. You may not be able to write an essay about it.
你可能无法清楚地表达你的理论，可能无法写一篇关于你的理论的文章。
Sometimes when people ask you to say your theories may be full of contradiction, but you do have a value system in you.
你的理论可能充满矛盾，但你的内心确实有一个价值体系。
You have a theory in you as you live.
当你活着的时候，你是持有一个理论的。
You have an understanding about the meaning of life, about what is good and what is not, what is valuable and what is not valuable.
你对生命的意义，何为好坏，何为有价值、无价值的，都有自己的一套理解。
You act and you act according to it. So do I.
然后你我都照着我们的理论而行。
So it is not sound to say all we need is to be practical and do not worry about the theory.
所以我们不能说我们需要的只是实用性，不用担心理论。
It's not sound to say all we need is good works and don't worry about the understanding of why we do that work.
我们需要的只是善行，不必担心什么，为什么要那么做。
No, because without the right theory, without the right understanding of God and how He prepares us for His work, your works is not going to have lasting and valuable benefits.
不行，因为如果没有正确的理论，如果不正确认识神，不了解神如何预备我们去做他的工，那你的工作就不会带来持久而有价值的益处。
So the conflict between pragmatism and the practicality of Christianity is at this level.
所以实用主义和基督教的实际性之间的冲突就在这个层面。
And I think R.C. Sproul defines it neatly here. Now listen to what he said.
我认为史普罗对这个做出了明确的定义。
Now he said, pragmatism is a theory of truth, while practicality is a test for truth.
史普罗说，实用主义是关于真理的理论，实际性是检查真理的标准。
Now you got to grasp the critical distinction.
我们必须掌握其中的关键。
Now where does the distinction lies?
那个区别在哪里呢？
Now theory of truth and test for truth. The two different words is theory and test.
这两个关键字眼，一个是理论，一个是检验。
Now, you have to see, okay, for practicality, we have our theories, right? I've just said, nobody operates without a theory.
刚才我已经说了，我们是实际的，但是我们也有我们的理论。
But we test them to see whether they are validated or falsified.
但是我们必须测试我们的理论，来看他们是有效的还是被证伪的。
Now, when I talk about the word test, do you remember Romans 12?
当我说到测试，你讲到罗马书第十二章吗？
When the apostle finished with the content of the gospel from Romans 1 to 11, now he teach believers about the practical aspect of Christian living.
当保罗在罗马书的前十一章讲完了福音过后，在罗马书十二章，保罗就教导基督徒生活的实际方面。
And verse 2, he went on to instruct believers to what? To test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will.
罗马书十二章第二节，保罗教导信徒要查验神的旨意是什么，神的善良、纯全、可喜悦的旨意。
You saw that? Test and approve. That's the practicality side of Christianity.
所以查验，这就是基督教实际的一面。
With the principle and the promise given through the gospel, test and approve God's will at this juncture.
凭着福音所赐下的原则和应许，查验此时此刻神的旨意是什么。
It could come in the form of convictions, it could come in the form of circumstances. God is leading nevertheless, but you got to test it.
这旨意可能借着感动被显明，可能借着环境被显明，但无论如何，神仍在带领，你必须查验。
Is this the way He's leading, or is this how He's leading? Test it.
这是神带领我去的地方吗？这是神带领我的方式吗？
For instance, we just finished with the renovation. We're moving here. It's full of challenges. We know that.
比如说，我们要搬到这个新的教会场所是一个挑战。
And we face a lot of hiccup.
有很多的波折。
But then, just as we pray and then we test what is God's will, whether when we should move in, how we should move in, you know, there's a lot of testing.
所以我们需要经过很多的查验、祷告来查验什么时候是最佳搬过来的时机，
just,
还有以怎样的方式来搬进来。
And yeah, is this the way God wants us to move in? And no, there's a lot of testing. You know, we are not talking about God outside the picture in renovation.
所以我们需要很多的查验，我们不是在这个装修的事上把神排外。
But pragmatism is different.
但是实用主义却不同。
Pragmatism as an ism is a theory of truth.
实用主义作为一种主义是一种真理理论。
Listen, the pragmatist says,If it works, it is the truth.
实用主义者会说，如果有效，那就是真理。
If it works, it is definitely good.
如果有效的话，那绝对是好的。
For the singer, if you could find a date, doesn't matter how you find it anyway.
对单身人士来说，如果你能够找到一个约会对象，不管你用什么方法找到就好。
For troubled couple, you know, if you can make your marriage work and you can make your wife happy, that's it. You know, just do it.
对于陷入困境的夫妻来说，如果你能够让婚姻好起来，让你的太太好起来，那就好了。
For the parent who have problem with the children, as long your child listens to you, that's it. You know.
对于苦恼的父母来说，如果你能让孩子听你的话，那就好了。
If you can find a solution to it, it is good, definitely good.
如果你找到那个解决方案，那就是好的。
Doesn't matter by what means. You don't have to concern yourself with any principles or any ideals.
你不需要担心你用什么方式或者是什么原则什么理想。
As long as it works.
只要有效行得通就好。
It is the theory for truth. You get what I mean?
所以这个只是一个真理的理论。
But remember, although it sounds very practical, it built into that is a skepticism towards the understanding of transcendent norms, the supernatural.
但是我们要记住，虽然这个听起来很实际，但是其中包含了对超然规范的怀疑态度。
Remember what I said just now? You know, pragmatism, it doesn't concern itself with what is of metaphysical or theological.
记得我刚才说的吗？实用主义不关心形而上学或神学的内容。
You can either put God out of the picture altogether, or you could say, as long as it works, it must be from God.
你要么就是把神完全排除在外，要么你就可以说，只要一样东西是有效，它肯定就是来自神的。
And how many times you hear from people who say, we don't have to worry too much about ethical concerns or moral implications, as long it works, it's from God. Maybe God wants to bless you this way, you know?
我们已经有多少次听到人家这么说，我们不必担心伦理问题或是道德含义，只要它有效，它就是来自神的。
Now, one of the very ironies of American history is that at Harvard University in the 19th century, there was a group of philosophy students who started a club.
美国历史上有一个非常讽刺的事件，就是在19世纪的哈佛大学，有一群哲学系的学生成立了一个俱乐部。
And that club was named Metaphysical Club.
那俱乐部被命名为形而上学俱乐部。
And that is to say they defined the goal of their club to specialize in concerns of metaphysical nature.
也就是说他们将俱乐部的目标定为专门关注形而上学。
And there were three men who were members of the club and who were also classmates.
当时有三名男子是该俱乐部的成员，他们也是同学。
Now, you should know their names if you study pragmatism. They were William James, Charles Peirce, and Oliver Wendell Holmes Jr. Three of them, along with John Dewey, you know, the humanist we spoke about in the last session, you know.
这三名同学是威廉·詹姆、查尔斯·比尔士。小奥里弗·温德尔·霍姆斯，还有我们上一次培训当中提到的人本主义者约翰·杜威。
Guess what? They started the Metaphysical Club, but eventually they all became the leading spokesman for the philosophy of pragmatism in American culture.
虽然他们开始了形而上学俱乐部，但是他们最终都成为美国文化中实用主义哲学的主要代言人。
In other words, pragmatism grew out historically of a group of fellows in a little fraternity in Harvard who were initially committed to the precepts of metaphysics.
换句话说，从历史上看，实用主义源于哈佛大学的一个小兄弟会的一群成员，他们最初致力于形而上学的戒律。
And why is that so?
为何会这样呢?
Because out of their growing spirit of skepticism towards understanding transcendent norms, these fellows began to look for alternative approach to things.
因为当人们对理解超越规范越来越持着怀疑心态时，这些人开始寻找另一套方法。
And they came to the conclusion and said, okay, we cannot know ultimate reality.
所以他们说，我们无法知道最终的现实。
We cannot know ultimate value.
我们无法知道最终的价值。
We can't go to the other side. It's beyond us. We are stuck here.
我们不能去到另一边，它超出了我们的范围。
So how do we know what is right?
那我们怎么知道什么是正确的？
Well, by what they call experimentation.
就是要借着实验。
Now, experimentation.
实验。
Now listen to this, it's very relevant to many of the pragmatists.
所以这个罪很多实用主义者都是非常贴切的。
Now, what do you mean by experimentation?
实验是什么意思呢？
Now, William James, how does he approach religion in an experimental way?
威廉·詹姆他如何看待宗教呢？
Now, he has written a classic called The Variety of Religious Experience, where he analyzes your experience.
他写了一本经典著作，名为《宗教经验之种种》。他在其中分析了人的经历。
So if you are a Christian, you go to Dr. James, and this is what he will ask you.
如果你说你是基督徒，你去找詹姆斯博士，他会这样跟你说。
He tries to analyze you, and he asks, "Tell me about your Christian experience."
他为了分析你，他首先会问你，请告诉我你的基督徒经历。
And then you probably say, "Well, I grew up in such and such a home, and then I had a crisis, and somehow I managed to know some friends when I was in my teenage years." And I was brought to church, and then I accepted Jesus.
你可能会说，我是在这样一个家庭长大的，然后我有一次危机的经历，在我十多岁的时候，我认识了一些朋友，他们向我介绍了基督教，然后我就信了。
And then Dr. James will try to probe and see how your attitude has changed, how your behavioral pattern has changed, how your inner feelings have changed in the course of that.
詹姆斯博士就会开始探究，看看你的态度如何改变，你的行为，你的内心感受如何改变。
And then he will probe, has this been a positive or negative experience for you in your life?
然后他会问，这对你来说是积极的还是消极的经历？
And you probably say, well, it has been a positive experience.
你会说这是积极的经历。
And then Dr. James will form the conclusion saying, okay, so for you, religion works.
因此他得出的结论是，对你来说宗教是有效的。
It helps you cope. It helps you make it in life.
它可以帮助你应对生活，它可以帮助你在生活中取得成功。
So for you, religion is good and true.
所以对你来说宗教是美好而真实的。
Now, sounds practical, right?
这听起来很实用。
But what does that say about God at this point?
但是这对于当时神是否存在有什么说明呢？
It says nothing.
他什么也没说。
In fact, by saying that, it is assuming that God is only true subjectively.
这样的说法是假设上帝只有在主观上是真实的。
It is only true as to how the individual experiences him.
神的真实性是凭着个人如何体验到神。
In fact, it's blatantly making the existence of God relative.
这是公然将神的存在相对化。
And many people are buying into that sort of argument now.
而很多人都接受这种观点。
Now, let me say this. For your knowledge, for earlier pragmatists, incidentally, they believed that there was a God, although they couldn't know too much about him.
早期的实用主义者相信有一位神，虽然他们对神不太了解。
Because the corporate experience of mankind tends to validate that there is a God in the earlier times.
因为在早期，人们认为人类的共同经验倾向于证实神存在的观点。
But later, pragmatists move away into a more atheistic band.
但后期的实用主义者偏离了这点，转向了更加无神论的倾向。
And the bottom line concern again was not whether there is such a thing as ultimate truth, because you can't know it, but what works is what matters.
但说到底，他们最关心的不是终极真理是否存在，因为人无法知道。但重要的是，什么才是行得通的。
Now, I don't know about you, but as a pastor, I always encounter people who embraces a kind of relativism with respect to truth and goodness.
身为一位牧师，我总是遇到一些对真理和良善抱有相对态度的人。
Now we talk about relativism in our next session, okay?
我们将在下一堂课中更加讨论相对主义。
Now, but I don't know if you have this.Experience where people come to you and ask you, "Hey, Vincent, do you believe in God?" Or so and so, you believe there's a God?
比如有人可能会问我们某某人，你们相信神吗？
And then you say, "Yes, I do."
然后你说我相信。
And then he asks, "Is it good for you? Does it make a difference to you in your life?"
然后他们会问，这对你好吗？这对你的生活有影响吗？
And I say, "Yes, it has helped me through a lot of things in my life."
然后你说是的，这个信仰帮助我度过了各种情况。
And then he forms a conclusion. Then in that case, God is true for you.
然后那人的结论就是，那么上帝对你来说是真实的。
But not for me, because I have get on with life without having to believe he's true at all.
但对我却不是如此，因为我完全不用相信神， so, 然后也可以继续生活。
Yeah, and for you, God is true, but not for me, because I don't believe him. I get on well.
所以对你来说神是真实的，但是对我来说神不是，因为没有神我也活得很好。
So I don't need to have a God.
所以我不需要神。
So what's going on here?
所以这是什么？怎么回事？
See, such people has redefined truth.
这样的人已经重新定义了真理。
They redefined by their experience, which is changing all the time.
他们是根据不断变化的经验来重新定义了真理。
Now what is truth?
那什么是真理？
You see, classically, truth is defined by what is real objectively.
经典的定义是，真理是由客观真实的事物来定义的。
But what, from what I've been just said, truth is determined by what works for me or for you or for another group of people or what?
然而现在从我所说的看来，真理取决于什么对我、对你或是对一群人是有效的。
And the problem comes in when it works for you, but it doesn't work for me.
但它 当它对你有用却对我起不了作用时，问题就来了。
And then you ask, what is truth now?
然后你就问，那现在什么才是真理？
And someone says, you can be both truth.
那有人说他们两者都可能是真的。
Then it's contradicting.
那是非常矛盾的。
Now, that's why one of the things that we got criticized by his critics in the area of epistemology is that he's full of subjectivism.
杜威在认识论研究领域受到批评的一点是他充满了主观主义。
And he never get out of it.
然后他从来没有摆脱这样的一个批评。
But it's a legitimate critic.
但这是一个合理的批评。
Because if I am the one who determine truth by what works for me, then the test for truth ultimately is my opinion, my subjective experience, so to speak.
因为如果我是以对我有用的东西来确定真理的人，那么检验真理的标准最终就是我的观点，也可以说是我的主观经验。
Now listen, when you say when you hear someone say, well, this thing works for me.
那你可能会听有些人说，这个对我很有用。
This thing works for me, Pastor.
牧师，这个对我很有效。
But the real question to ask is, how long does it work?
但我们真正要问的是，它能有效多久？
To what degree can it work?
它能行得通到什么程度？
So in one sense, I say, there is practicality for faith.
所以从某种意义上说，我说信仰是有实用性的。
Because I mean, yes, what good is faith if it doesn't work?
我的意思是，如果信仰不起作用，那它有什么益处呢？
But we also have to ask the obvious questions. What to what end?
但我们也必须问一个明显的问题，它是为什么目的而起作用的？
Work for what?
它是为了什么而行得通的？
If the truth is that which works, I have to add the question. Truth is that which works for what?
如果真理是有效的，我必须补充一个问题，就是真理是为了什么而起作用的？
What good is it producing ultimately?
它最终能产生什么好处？
I mean, let me explain. There are many things that can work in this world.
在这个世界上有很多事情可以有效。
It can work to bring short-term results.
它们也可以带来一些短期的结果。
For instance, you can give money to people to do your bidding.
比如说你可以给人钱来叫他们听从你的命令。
Increase the salary of the workers, then they will be motivated, you know, in this company.
你给你的员工加薪，他们就有动力来做工。
You can promise your child expensive trip, expensive gadgets, and motivate them to study.
你可以向你的孩子承诺一次昂贵的旅行或是昂贵的小玩意儿来激励他们用功读书。
Or as a church minister, you can have all the interesting programs, activities to get people into the church.
或者作为教会牧师，你可以举办很多有趣的节目和活动来吸引人来到教会。
You can lean your sermon towards what is culturally popular or those with problem-solving leanings.
你的讲道可以倾向文化流行的内容，或者倾向那些能解决问题的内容。
Example, 5 ways to handle difficult situation, 3 ways to achieve a happy marriage.
比如说应付困境的五种方法，享受幸福婚姻的三种 方法。
Now you can lean your message towards those problem-solving leanings rather than solid truths from deep biblical doctrine.
你的讲道可以倾向那些解决问题的 内容，而不是从深奥的圣经教义中汲取坚实的真理。
Does it work?
这一切管用吗？
Well, it seems so. People are happy listening to those messages.
似乎是因为人听了这些信息很开心。
It can be easily digest. It's workable for a while.
这个很容易消化，也可行。
Yes, it worked, but for how long?
这些都可以起作用，但是能够持续多久呢？
And to what end?
而它的目的又是什么呢？
So you see, if you are saying it works,
所以如果你说它有效，
you have to have some standard, some norms to determine whether the results are really, really good results.
你必须有一些标准、一些规范来判断这个结果是否真的是真正好的结果。
It cannot merely be a short-term preference or desirables that has no ultimate and substantial benefits.
它不能只是短期的偏好或愿望，而没有最终和实质性的益处。
There must be a long-range norm if you are talking about what is good.
如果我们谈论益处，就必须有一个长期的规范。
Example, if you're talking about marriage,
比如如果我们谈论婚姻
，it's not just making your wife happy.
它不仅仅是让你的妻子开心。
Both husband and wives must submit to what God has determined in a marriage.
丈夫和妻子两人都必须顺服上帝在婚姻中所定的事。
There must be godly principles in a marriage where true sacrifice happen in a marriage.
婚姻中必须有敬虔的原则和真正的牺牲。
You see, pragmatism doesn't care about these long-range norms.
实用主义并不关心这些长期规范。
It says, let's make it work now.
他说我们现在让它有效就好。
So another chief criticism of pragmatism is that it tends to only focus on short-term consequences.
因此对 实用主义的另一个主要批评是它倾向于关注短期后果。
So as I have said, it carries the motive of secularism where it is only concerned of the present.
我曾说过实用主义带有 世俗主义的主题就是只关注当下。
Why? Because it doesn't believe there is an ultimate benefit to be reaped.
为什么呢？因为它不相信能够获得最终的利益。
Now, let me say this. If you don't believe in the Bible, you don't believe in the ultimate, right?
如果你不相信圣经，你就不相信终极。
Which also means you don't believe in the principles that will bring you there.
也意味着你不相信能够带你到达那里的原则。
Now, it's very important that you understand why principles is so important when we are talking about doing away with pragmatism.
当我们讲到我们要排除实用主义的时候，我们一定要明白为什么原则那么重要。
Now, principles are not there merely to tell us that there is a God who created all things and He instituted the way all things operate.
原则不仅仅是告诉我们有一位创造了万物的上帝，并且他制定了万物运作的方式。
Principles also tell us the sure way to achieve the ultimate blessings from God.
原则还告诉我们有一个可靠的方法可以获得上帝的最终祝福。
Now, I always say this to parents who have problems with their children.
我总是对那些与孩子有问题的父母说
You don't look at the way your children are behaving now.
你不要看你的孩子现在的行为。
You go by the parental principles that God has given for the raising of your child, and you will come to praise God at the end.
你只要遵从神为养育孩子所赐下的父母原则，到最后你必会赞美神。
But pragmatism tells you to forego all these principles. It's no use. Doesn't work. You've tried so long. Doesn't work.
但是实用主义是叫你放弃这些原则的。他告诉你，你已经尝试这么久的都行不通。
Now I want to draw an example about the American social reforms, which is something that land the nation in greater debts each year.
我想举一个关于美国社会改革的例子，它使国家每年背负越来越多的债务。
Now we go back to what Harvey Cox said about John F. Kennedy as the symbol of pragmatism.
我们回到考克斯谈到肯尼迪是实用主义的象征。
Now Cox also spoke about an earlier President Roosevelt, as an analysis of his American pragmatic culture.
考克斯也谈到了一位早期的总统。罗斯福作为他对美国实用主义文化的分析。
Now, if you don't know who is Roosevelt, he's the president that bring America through the World War II.
罗斯福总统是带领国家度过第二战的。
Now, during then, the nation is paralyzed, caught in the grip of depression, the economy is collapsed.
在那期间，国家陷入瘫痪，陷入萧条，经济崩溃。
The forward growth and progress of America have come to a screeching halt. Industry shut down.
美国的发展和进步戛然而止，工业停产。
And high rate of unemployment hit the country. People are barely surviving.
国家失业率居高不下，人们勉强生存。
And the war in Europe is mounting, and then America is in a crisis place of leadership.
战争的幽灵正在欧洲加剧，而美国的领导地位也处于危机之中。
And then Roosevelt, he came into the White House.
随后。 罗斯福就进了白宫。
Now, he is the man that made famous the concept of the 100 days in office.
他是使上任百日概念闻名的人。
Now, have you heard of this word, the 100 days? How the president and prime minister perform in the first 100 days?
这个就是有关总统或是总理上任一百天的评价。
And this concept is actually made famous by Roosevelt.
这是罗斯福他使之闻名的。
And how was Roosevelt in the first 100 days of his presidential office?
那么罗斯福上任的头一百天是怎样的呢？
In short, he passed more legislation in the first 100 days than any president would have done in a whole term.
简单来说，他在头一百天内通过的立法，比任何一位总统在整个任期内通过的立法还要多。
This is what he said. We have problems now.
他说，我们现在有问题。
We don't have time to sit around and think through all the long-range repercussions.
我们没有时间坐下来思考所有的长期影响。
We got to act now and solve the problem now.
我们必须立即采取行动，立即解决问题。
People are out of work.Put them back to work.
人们失业了，我们就让他们工作。
Doesn't matter with the budget.
与预算无关。
We worry about that later.
我们稍后再担心。
And then he start to introduce the new program of reform.
所以他就提出了新的改革计划。
Social security, heavier tax on the wealthy, new controls over banks and public utilities and so on.
社会保障对富人征税，对银行和公共事业的新控制等等。
And this is Roosevelt.
所以这个是罗斯福。
And then Harvey Cox said, Kennedy's style was similar to that, or even more deliberate.
而考克斯表示，肯尼迪的风格跟罗斯福很相似，甚至更加的慎重。
Kennedy was even more pragmatic, which is so pervasive in American culture.
肯尼迪的风格更加务实，而这在美国文化中非常普遍。
When Kennedy was in office, it was in the 60s, and the country was bogged down in problems.
肯尼迪执政时是1960年代，那时国家陷入困境。
And that style of Roosevelt that was totally embraced by Kennedy is the style of what? Is the style of problem solving. Now we always hear these words.
肯尼迪完全接受罗斯福那解决问题的风格。
Now we call this the American way of life.
我们称之为美国生活方式。
And we Singaporeans are so embedded in this sort of culture also.
我们新加坡人也深深地融入这种文化当中。
And you don't believe it, you leave this country, you go to our neighboring country.
如果你不相信，我们离开我们的国家，我们去到邻国。
And then we want to buy something and queues form, you know, delays form, they just drive us nuts, right?
然后我们看到要排队，然后有延误，然后这让我们很抓狂。
Because we Singaporeans are programmed to want things work and to work fast.
因为我们新加坡人生来就是希望事情能够顺利进行，而且要快速进行。
Our goals are always to look for solutions, immediate solutions to resolve slowness, resolve hiccups, troubleshoot, get things done immediately, save the hazard, deliver the results, right?
我们的目标始终是寻找解决方案，立即解决那个缓慢的问题，要排查故障，立即完成工作，省去麻烦，交付成果。
Now, I appreciate certain things should be done this way without procrastination.
我也觉得某些事情应该以这种方式来完成，不要拖延。
And honestly, I also hate procrastination.
老实说，我也讨厌拖延。
But I also recognize that not all problems can be resolved fast.
但我也晓得，并不是所有的问题都能很快得到解决。
There are problems which will have long-term repercussions if we would just want to resolve it in the short term.
有些问题，如果我们只想在短期内解决，就会产生长期影响。
For instance, human relationship.
比如人际关系。
You cannot force it on people.
你不能勉强人。
Right? You know, there's a lot of things, a lot of runnings in the church. You cannot push each other and to get things done.
教会有很多的运作，我们不能强逼人来办成事情。
You gotta make people understand.
我们要让人能够明白。
Well, you come to that, okay? But let's come back. What Kennedy believed was.If there is a problem, you solve it. Don't procrastinate.
回到肯尼迪，他所相信的就是，如果你有问题，就解决它，不要拖延。
But you see, let me say, but the way if we go about the pragmatists, if you have a problem, you want to solve it quickly, if you haven't thought through enough, it will ultimately bring you to two problems.
但是当你要解决问题，但是你没有好好思想的时候，你会发现这个解决方案它会最后带给你另外两个问题。
Now, for instance, okay, for instance, this is the situation in America. There's a problem with people reaching retirement age that they haven't saved enough money to care for themselves in the old age.
比如现在美国有一个问题，就是人们到了退休年龄，却没有存足够的钱来照顾自己的晚年。
Now, it was the problem then, okay?
这是美国当时的问题。
And then what do you do?
那你怎么办呢？
Now, the logical way is to create an enforced retirement savings plan.
一个有逻辑的方案就是制定一项强制退休储蓄计划。
I'm sure you know this. Singapore, we call it CPF. In Malaysia, we call it EPF, right?
在新加坡，我们称之为公积金。
And then people began to think that, okay, with enforced retirement plan now, it will cover our needs, but they didn't consider what? They didn't consider inflation.
然后人们就以为退休储蓄计划能够满足他们的需求，但是他们没有考虑到通货膨胀。
I'm sure you know what's inflation. You feel it now.
我相信大家都知道什么是通货膨胀，现在能够感受到。
Used to be a bowl of noodles for $2, now it's $5.
一碗面之前是两块钱，现在是五块钱。
So when inflation comes, people retire and then realize they don't have enough social security they thought they have.
因此通货膨胀来时，人们退休了，并发现自己没有他们以为所拥有的社会保障。
But during then, it's another president. So the president will say, now let's supplement it.
所以当时有另一个总统，那个总统就说我们政府要开始补充。
And then the government spends huge amount on social security, and pretty soon it becomes an elephant that was to sink the whole ship.
然后政府在社会保障上投入巨资，而那很快就造成更大的问题。
And that is why America is the country which has the largest debt in the world.
这也是为什么美国是世界上外债最多的国家。
You know, I just read about it. You know, last year, December, the debt of America, the federal debt went up to $33 trillion.
截至去年12月，联邦债务总额约为33万亿美元。
It's simply not repayable.
这是根本无法偿还的数目。
No country dare to tell America pay back, no.
也没有任何国家敢向美国索取这个债务。
But they know the debt is beyond payable.
但是他们都知道这个债务是无法偿还的。
And what's the cause of it?
然后其原因是什么呢？
Pragmatism.
实用主义。
And that is why our Singapore government has always warned about country going the Western way of giving social security. You understand?
这也是为什么新加坡政府一直警告我国不要走西方社会保障的路。
And Prime Minister always says, "Small nation like us, without natural resources, we cannot finance it." You know,
我们的总理常常说，像我们这样的小国，我们没有天然资源，我们没有办法提供那样的资金。
But without social security, we have to be very careful about letting people use their retirement savings. You know.
但如果没有社会保障，我们就必须非常小心的让人们使用他们退休的存款。
And then more thoughts have to put into how to help people invest their CPF money and all.
我们也必须投入更多的精神来帮助人们投资退休储蓄。
And then encourage people to work longer.
也要鼓励人们工作更长时间。
And some people complain, you know, why I cannot take out my own money, you know, why I have to work longer, right?
有些人投诉为什么我的钱还拿不出来，为什么我要做工这么久？
But that is why if a government is only pragmatic in approach, it will only introduce populistic policy, which in time to come will bankrupt the nation.
如果政府只采取务实态度，只会推行民粹政策，那他迟早就会让国家破产。
I think government will thank me for saying this. Okay.
可能政府会感谢我这么说。
But anyway, in that sense, similar to humanism, what I'm saying is pragmatism lives on borrowed capital.
所以类似于人本主义，实用主义靠借来的资本生存。
It is spending the borrowed money now without thinking about the future.
他现在就花掉借来的钱，而不考虑未来。
It is cashing on what benefits or what feels good now without thinking about the later generations.
他利用现在的好处或感觉良好的东西，而不考虑后代。
But why don't people see it?
但为什么人们看不到呢？
Why?
为什么?
Because those devastating problems don't happen in 3 weeks or 3 months.
因为那些毁灭性的问题不会在三周或是三个月内发生。
It happened in 30 years or 40 years time.
但是那是在三十年、四十年后才会发生的。
Now, if you execute short-term solution, it creates two problems out of one problem.
如果你执行短期解决方案，就会产生一个问题会产生两个问题。
If you go on, it will create 4 problems or 8 problems or 16 problems, it will have a multiplier effect.
然后再这样持续下去，你就会有四个问题、八个问题、十六个问题。
And then the problems of the culture escalate and explode, and then it will bring down the whole house crashing down.
然后文化问题不断的升级和爆发，最终导致严重的后果。
This is what you will get in the end if you go on implementing short-term solutions.
如果我们继续施行短期解决方案，这就是我们最终会得到的结果。
Now listen, this is the principle of things.
这个就是事情的原理。
God has embedded in nature certain principles that the pragmatist has always choose to ignore either ignorantly or blatantly.
上帝在大自然中蕴含了某些原则，而实用主义者总是无知的或公然的选择忽视这些原则。
And I say this not only to mean what is of financial, but more importantly, what is spiritual, what is psychological, or what is relational even.
我这样说不仅是指财务上的，更重要的是属灵上的、心理上的、关系上的。
Now we have to think things through carefully.
我们必须认真思考。
Now this is the point where the Bible says, truth is that which works, but that which works must be measured by the eternal norms of God.
这就是圣经所说的，真理就是行之有效的，而行之有效的必须以神永恒的标准来衡量。
Now listen to this. The real conflict between Christianity and pragmatism is the conflict between what is right and what is expedient.
基督教与实用主义之间的真正冲突是正确与权益之间的冲突。
Now I say it again. The conflict between Christianity and pragmatism is the conflict between what is right and what is expedient.
基督教与实用主义之间的真正冲突是正确与权益之间的冲突。
Now, what is expediency? Expediency is talking about a course of action that is taken for its practicality rather than its moral or ethical considerations.
那什么是权益之计呢？权益之计是指出于实用性而非道德或伦理考量而采取的行动。
Now, where do you see this in the Bible?
我们在圣经哪里会看到这个？
I point you to a story, a very familiar one. You see this in the story of Esau selling his birthright for what is expedient.
我们从我们很熟悉的以扫的故事看到这个，他为了权益而出卖了自己长子的名分。
Now you see that account in Genesis 25 where Esau came from the open country, he was famished.
在创世纪第25章，我们知道以扫从田野饿着肚子回来。
And then he asked his brother Jacob for some of the red stew he just cooked.
他向他的兄弟雅各要了一些雅各煮的红汤。
And Jacob responded by saying, "Can, but first sell me your birthright." Right?
雅各回答说，你要先把你的长子名分卖给我。
And what was Esau's reply?
然后以扫怎么回答？
Now this is what he said. He said, "Look, brother, I am about to die of hunger."
以扫说，我将要死了，我要饿死了。
What good is the birthright to me?
这长子的名分与我有什么益处呢？
So what do we see? What do we see?
我们看到了什么？
Esau cares nothing about the promises of birthright.
以扫并不关心长子权的应许。
To him, the immediate hunger and physical need far supersedes the benefits of God's promise.
对以扫来说，饥饿和身体的需要远远超过了上帝应许的好处。
And being expedient in satisfying his need has always been his inclination.
满足他自己的需要一直是他的倾向。
Now, I point you to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 16.
那我们看希伯来书十二章。
And this is where God spoke about the permanent consequences of Esau's expediency pursuit.
神谈到了以扫追求权益之计的永久后果。
Hebrews 12, 16. See that no one is sexually immoral or is godless like Esau. How godless is he? He, for a single meal, sold his inheritance rights as the oldest son. Afterward, as you know, when he wanted to inherit this blessing, he was rejected. Although he sought the blessings with tears, he could not change what he had done.
希伯来书十二章，又免得有人成为淫乱和恋贪恋世俗的，好像以扫一样，为了一点点食物，竟把自己长子的名分出卖了。你们知道，后来以扫想要承受祝福，却被拒绝了。他虽然带着眼泪寻求，还是没有反悔的余地。
Now, what caught me about this verse is the permanent effects brought about by Esau's pragmatistic tendency.
我在这节经文注意到的是以扫的实用主义倾向所带来的永久后果。
Look at the verse where I underline, he could not change what he had done.
圣经说他为他所做的事没有反悔的余地。
He could not change the consequences.
他无法改变后果。
Now wisdom tells us that there are certain things where there can be no reversal.
智慧告诉我们有些事情是无法逆转的。
And as the saying goes, don't cry over spilled milk.
俗语说覆水难收后悔莫及
It's spilled. You know, you can't get it back.
已经泼出去的水很难收回来
If you have chosen to pursue worldly riches all your life, you don't expect godly riches.
如果你选择一生追求世俗的财富就不要期待属灵的财富
If you have started to enjoy sex outside marriage, don't expect to enjoy the fullness of God's blessing in marital union.
如果你已经开始享受婚外性行为就不要指望在婚姻关系当中享受神丰盛的祝福。
If you have chosen shortcuts, don't expect long-range blessings.
如果你选择了捷径，就不要期待长期的祝福。
If you have chosen pragmatism over godly principle, you have to live with its consequences.
如果你选择实用主义而不是金钱原则，你就必须承受其后果。
The tears and pain will be so much to bear as in the case of Esau.
就像以扫的例子一样，眼泪和痛苦是难以忍受的。
Oh, someone say, "Hey, Pastor, didn't Christianity talks about repentance? We can repent, right?"
那有些人说，牧师，难道基督教不是讲悔改的吗？我们可以悔改啊。
Yes, we can repent.
的确可以悔改。
But what I'm trying to say here is that it gets even harder to repent each time when you have gone the way of pragmatism.
然而当你走上实用主义的道路时悔改就会变得更加困难。
It gets even harder to change the course of action after that.
改变行为就变得更加困难。
Now think about a child.
试想一个孩子。
You started to give him handphones and iPad when he was a toddler so that he can be emotionally better handled.
当他还是幼儿的时候你就开始给他手机和 iPad 以致他能够更好地应付他的情绪
and give this device to him and he can be coaxed to take his meal obediently you know?
以致你可以哄他乖乖吃饭
and by the time you realize he's not focusing in his studies not greeting people but constantly glued to the screen you know?
但当你意识到他没有专心读书他也没有和人打招呼只是一直盯着他的屏幕时
You try taking away his device, and you will know how hard it is.
到时你想试着拿走他的手机或是平面电脑，你就会知道那是有多困难的事。
It gets harder each time when you have gone the way of expediency.
每次我们选择权宜之计时，事情就会变得更加困难。
Whether you are a parent, you are a businessman, politician, an employee, or even a church minister, the seduction of the philosophy of pragmatism is real.
无论你是父母、商人、政治家、普通员工，甚至是教会牧师，实用主义哲学的诱惑都是真实的。
Now, I want to end with something that's very close to my heart, especially about how I've struggled with pragmatism.
我想以一个非常贴近我的心的事情来结束，特别是我如何与实用主义征战。
Now, I served the Lord full time 2 years after I graduated from uni.
我大学毕业2年后就开始服侍主。
In fact, I've served the Lord.Full-time all of my adult life.
事实上我成年后一直都在服侍主。
I remember vividly for the first 10 years of my full-time ministry, I myself was struggling so much in this society of pragmatism.
我清楚记得我全职侍奉的头10年,我发现自己在这个实用主义的社会里挣扎得很厉害。
Because wherever I turn to, whether it's my brethren, my school friends, my parents, teachers, or even as a citizen in this society,I find myself having to swim against the tide of pragmatism all the time.
因为无论我走到哪里，无论我是跟我的弟兄、学校朋友、父母，还是仅仅作为这个社会的公民，我发现自己不得不对抗这整个实用主义的信仰和文化。
Not only outside church, even inside church.
不只是在教会以外，而且也是在教会以内。
In fact, merely by looking at how the broad evangelical churches run their ministries, I can't help feeling that pragmatism was the main driving motive rather than what is principle, what is spiritual.
事实上，单单观察广泛的福音派教会如何运作他们的事工，我不禁感到实用主义才是驱动教会的主题，而不是原则或是属灵的事。
Everyone was talking about growing their church as a measure of success.
每个人都把教会的发展作为衡量成功的标准。
Ministers and even mature Christians whom I spoke to tell me how I have to strategize my ministries.
与我交谈的牧师甚至成熟的基督徒告诉我如何制定我的施工策略。
I read about articles about how Christian leaders draw crowd with their charisma.
我也读了关于基督教领袖如何使用他们的魅力来吸引人群的文章。
And in a nutshell, ministers have to think creatively and strategically to lure their crowd into the church.
简单的说，牧师们必须有创意性和战略性的思考，以吸引人群到教会来。
And I'm also exposed to the idea about how church leaders engaging the help of psychological assessment to get the right mix of people to co-work.
此外，我也了解到教会领袖如何借助心理评估的帮助，找到合适的人员组合来一起同工。
And these pragmatic methodologies get into the mainstream churches, and yeah, sometimes there are great testimonies of how they work out.
这些实用的方法进入了主流教会，有时也会有关于他们如何发挥作用的见证。
I was so tempted to go the way of pragmatism for the running of the church.
所以我也受到引诱，想以实用主义来管理教会。
But the Lord kept me.
但主保守了我。
I remember as a young pastor in my early 30s.
我记得我当我是三十出头的年轻牧师时
，I was convinced those things that are mentionedthat I was exposed to were not from the Lord, but from the world.
我确信那些不是来自神，而是来自世界。
I find myself convinced to swim against the tide of this pragmatic society, which I believe have influenced the mainstream evangelical churches.
我深信自己要在这个务实社会的潮流逆流而上。我相信实用主义已经影响了主流福音派教会了。
And also convicted that my calling was to preach a gospel,which was inherently God-given, and therefore, everything about his work has to be God-driven.
我深信我的呼召就是要传讲神赐予的福音，因此有关神的事工都应该是神为的。
I was convinced that no one can practice pragmatism in Christianity and claim true success.
我确信没有人能够以实用主义实践基督教并得着真正的成功。
And that actually prompted me to write a blog post, which still can be found in WordPress today, entitled What Works and What's Right.
这就促使我写了一篇博文，今天仍然可以在 WordPress 上找到，标题为什么是有效的，什么是正确的。
And when I was preparing this lecture, I recall that article that I wrote 11 years ago and went back to it.
当我在准备这堂课时，我想起了我11年前写的那篇文章。
And I praise God,that he has kept me from the trappings of pragmatism.
我赞美神，他让我摆脱了实用主义的陷阱。
Now, in that article, if you have time to read it, okay? In that article, I have asserted that the only reason why we fail to get practical guidance of God is because, categorically speaking, we've lost our pure devotion towards his word.
在那篇文章中我断言我们未能得到神实际引导的唯一原因是我们失去了对神话语的专一敬虔。
And I've said, so many ministers love to preach what works than what's right.
很多牧师他们喜欢宣讲的是有效的方法而不是正确的方法。
Pulpit message in the churches has a general leaning towards problem solving rather than enlightening believers about God's truth.
教会的讲台信息普遍倾向于解决问题，而不是启发信徒明白神的真理。
And in that article, I say to those who always claim they don't get practical help from the Bible.
在那篇文章中，我对那些总是声称自己没有从阅读圣经中获得实际帮助的人说话。
Now I say, let me reiterate, I'm not against anything that's practical.
我要再重申，我并不反对实际的事。
In fact,The God that I know gives me practical solutions.
事实上，我所认识的神给了我实际的解决方法。
He always provides a way out for me without which I will not be able to lead my family or my church to what it is today.
神实际的提供了我出路，不然我就无法带领我的家庭和教会走到今天。
But biblical practicality rests upon a simple truth.
但圣经的实用性建立在一个简单的真理之上。
That is, it is the word of God that creates everything.
那就是神的话创造了一切。
Remember, Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, God said, let there be light, and there was light.
记得我们在创世纪读，神说，有光就有光。
And the whole universe came into existence because of God's word.
然后整个宇宙就借着神的话而被创造了。
With His word, God creates the heavens, the earth, and our very soul even.
神用他的话语创造了天地，甚至是我们的灵魂。
So there can never be one instance or problem that the word of God is lacking in substance or solutions.
所以神的话永远不可能没有实质内容或解决方法。
From every problem, every minute problem we face in this, big or small, and right down to every mental and emotional struggle of man, God's word is ever potent and workable, and it's for the believing heart to claim it.
从我们在这个世上所面临的每一个大小的问题，到人类每一个精神情感上的挣扎，神的话都是有效和可行的，而只有相信的心才能领受。
I give you Proverbs 3, 5, 6.
箴言书第三章五到六节。
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him and He will make your path straight.
你要专心仰赖耶和华，不可倚靠自己的聪明，在你一切所行的事上都要认定他，他必指引你的路。
You see, there's a definite promise given here that He will straighten the paths of all who trust Him.Fully.
神在这里给了明确的应许，他会为那些信靠他的人修直道路。
Yet, don't think by just trusting God once and then things will work out.
然而，不要以为只要相信神一次，事情就会好起来。
We are worshiping God, not a genie.
我们敬拜的是神，而不是精灵。
Now, and one more thing, I'd like to give glory to God.
还有一件事，我想将荣耀归给神。
Now, it occurs to me when I wrote that article, I was not exposed to anything that was categorically reformed.
当我写那篇博文时，我发现我并没有接触到任何明显的改革教导。
I wasn't trained in seminary.
我也没有在神学院受过培训。
No one taught me how to raise a church.
没有人教我如何建立一间教会。
All I know simply is that the gospel is from God, and everything about churchMust be done God's way.
我只知道福音是从神而来的，所以教会的一切都必须按照神的方式去做。
So good riddance with pragmatism.
所以应该摆脱实用主义。
Now, just a decade had went by, just a decade, and I thank God that I was not only kept from succumbing to a pragmatic belief, but I am beginning to reap the glorious fruits of faithfulness.
现在十年已经过去了，我感谢上帝，我不但没有屈服于实用主义的信念，而且开始收取忠心的荣耀 果子。
I feel I want to share this because I want to help you.
我想要分享这个来帮助人。
And I share this to all of you, especially who wants to start right as a good and faithful minister.
我想向所有想要成为一名忠心良善仆人的分享这些。
Listen.Be faithful to the gospel and do not quench the Holy Spirit.
我们必要忠于福音而不要消灭圣灵的感动。
Then you will receive the counsel of God in all your ways.
然后你就会在你一切所行的事上得到神的引导。
Don't give in an inch to pragmatism.
不要向实用主义让步。
You hold on to the eternal truths and norms and do not exchange that birthright for the short-term benefits of expediency.
我们要坚守永恒的真理和规范，不要用长子权来换取短期的权益利益。
Let's go to the Lord in prayer.
我们一起来祷告。
Father, we thank you so much for this message on pragmatism.
神，我们为着今天这个实用主义的信息来感恩。
We saw its danger and subtlety.
我们看到它的危险还有微妙之处。
In fact, right in this society of ours, the culture is all surrounding us.
在我们这样一个社会，这样一个实用主义的文化环绕着我们。
We have been programmed or shaped so much by how this pragmatic society runs.
我们被这个实用主义的社会所塑造。
But Lord, today, by the power of your word,
但是今天借着神你话语的能力
Restore us
求神你恢复，叫我们恢复。
Put in us a godly resistance to such a philosophy of life.
给我们一个神圣的抗拒力来拒绝这样一个人生的哲学。
Help us to stay true to biblical truths.
叫我们忠于圣经的真理。
Help us to be steadfast in the gospel.
叫我们在福音上能够站立得住。
And learn to be moved by the Holy Spirit in all our dealings.
叫我们在一切所行的事上能够被圣灵感动。
Help all of us here to be great witness.
帮助我们所有的人都成为神你很好的见证人。
That with the way we live, that people can see God in us.
以致借着我们的生活，人们从我们的身上可以看到神。
And how God deliver us through all the practical difficulties of our lives.
也看到神怎么样从叫我们从人生很多实际的问题中救出来。
In the name of Christ, we pray.
我们奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.